At first glance, you might think this is extreme sports for robots. However, the feats performed in this arena aren't for winning medals or setting records. They're helping a special breed of robots and their makers learn how to save lives. This is the Robotics Test Facility at the National Institute of Standards and Technology just outside Washington, D.C. It's here that first responders, bomb squads, manufacturers, and researchers come to find out what their emergency response robots can and cannot do. For example, can they maneuver through rubble? Can they close a valve leaking toxic gas? Or can they spot a victim buried in debris? The New York City Fire Department is one of the organizations using the NIST Robot Test Course to get some answers.
It's a way of, in a standardized fashion, to really go through and really test the robot out.
NIST engineers have designed more than 25 specific challenges to measure robot capabilities under disastrous circumstances. A field of debris becomes a floor of jutting 4x4s. An eye chart judges robots' vision in both light and dark. Ladders and stairs test mobility and agility.
Generally, we're generating standard test methods for robots. So standard test methods for robots implies that there's an apparatus, a procedure, a performance metric that others can replicate and perform their own testing. So a standard test method gives you the power to measure the robot's capability wherever you are, whenever you're testing.
And those tests can physically make their way around the globe as well, because each one is designed for easy transport and setup. To date, hundreds of response robots have had their abilities challenged by NIST. The impacts have been impressive, such as the Defense Department using NIST test results to guide its purchase of ultralight recon robots. Or how about Quince? This alumnus of the NIST performance testing program aided in the shutdown of Japan's Fukushima nuclear reactor, a job much too dangerous for humans. But for groups like the Fire Department of New York, the impact that matters most is making sure response robots will work when needed. As for the future, the NIST Robotics Test Facility and its clones now operating around the world will enable tomorrow's mechanical first responders to perform even better in the face of disaster.